So in this video, I'm going to talk about zero and negative exponents. So let's start with the power of zero. So if I have any number a, which is not equal to zero, and I take a and raise it to the power of zero, then my answer is going to be one. At the end of the video, I'll talk about why this is true. So for example, if I have 2 to the power of zero, well, I'm going to get 1. If I have 6 to the power of zero, then that will equal 1. If I have 8.71 to the power of 0, that will also equal 1. Okay, so why don't you press pause on work and work on the 3 examples I'm going to put up. Okay, so press pause while you work on these 3 examples. Okay, so 7.9, that's not equal to 0, so this is a non-zero number being raised to the power of 0, so that's going to be equal to 1. Likewise, negative 8.4, that doesn't equal 0, and so when I raise it to the power of 0, I get 1. And negative 6 to the power of 0, so remember that this exponent here is not being applied to the negative here. So first we apply it to the 6, so we get negative 6 to the 0 is 1, so the answer of negative 6 to the 0 is going to be negative 1. All right, now let's talk about negative exponents. So let's look at these 4 examples. 5 to the power of negative 1 is defined to be 1 over 5 to the power of positive 1, which is the same as 1/5. 5 to the power of negative 2 is defined to be 1 over 5 to the power of positive 2. So that's going to equal 1 over 25. 5 to the negative 3, that's defined to be 1 over 5 to the positive 3. So that's going to be 1 over 125. And in fact, 5 to the negative of any number n is going to be 1 over 5 to the power of positive n. So in general, we have a to the power of negative n is equal to 1 over a to the power of n if a is a non-zero number. And I'll explain why this is true at the end of the video. All right, so let's work on these examples together. Okay, so let's look at this again. A to the power of negative n, how do I rewrite that? I have 1 over, I have my same base a, but now my power, once I move the a into the bottom, the power of a becomes the negative of this number. Okay, so if I have 8 to the power of negative 2, it's going to be 1 over 8 to the power of positive 2 instead. So that's going to be equal to 1 over 64. If I have 2 to the power of negative 1, again, that's going to be 1 over, I have the base of 2, so I keep my base, but now I'm going to have a positive 1 instead of a negative 1 as the power. And 2 to the power of positive 1 is equal to 2, so this is equal to 1/2. All right, negative 3 to the power of negative 3. So I'm going to have 1 over, I'm going to keep my same base of negative 3, but the power is going to become positive 3. So I have 1 over negative 3 to the power of 3, and so that's going to be 1 over negative 27, which is just equal to negative 1 over 27. Okay, x to the power of negative 6. I'm going to rewrite this so that my power is positive. So it's going to be 1 over the same base of x to the power of positive 6 now. All right, let's take a look at this one together, and then I'll give you some to work on to try on your own. All right, negative 1 over x to the power of negative 4. So I'm going to start by going to my denominator and rewriting that portion. So I still have the negative here. I have the 1 from here. I'm going to have my big fraction from here. And now I'm going to rewrite x to the negative 4 using a positive power. In order to do that, I'm going to say x to the negative 4 is 1 over, same base, so x. But now I've moved the x into the denominator here, so 1 over, so I make this negative 4 positive. So I have negative 1 divided by 1 over x to the power of 4. So, well, how do I do that? Well, that's the same thing as negative 1 over 1 in the numerator. So since my denominator is a fraction, I'm going to go ahead and write my numerator as a fraction. So that is going to be equal to 1 over 1 divided by 1 over x to the 4th. And the way we divide fractions is we take the numerator times the reciprocal of the denominator. So this is equal to negative 1 over 1 times the reciprocal of this denominator. So we flip the 1 to the bottom and the x to the 4th to the top. So this is negative 1 times x to the 4th. So x to the 4th. Divided by 1 times 1, which is 1. So our answer is equal to negative x to the 4th. All right, I'm going to give you guys one to try. All right, so negative 2 over x to the negative 5. Press pause and try to rewrite that without negative exponents. Okay, so just no negative in the exponent. Okay, so like last time, we're going to have this negative. We have the 2 in the top over x to the negative 5, that's 1 over x to the positive 5. And so again, I'm going to have my negative here. I'm going to write my 2 as a fraction since my denominator is a fraction. So I get negative 2 over 1 over 1 over x to the 5th. So I'm going to take the negative of my numerator times the reciprocal of this denominator. So that's going to be x to the 5th over 1. So negative 2 over 1 times x to the 5th over 1 is equal to negative 2 x to the 5th over 1 times 1. So simply negative 2x to the power of 5. All right, so there's a shortcut we can take here, because that's kind of a lot of steps. So the shortcut we can take, we're gonna take a look at something here. So in this first example, it simply ended up being negative x to the 4th. So the shortcut that I can take is I can say, all right, I've got this negative power in my denominator, and I want to make it positive. So the way that I can make it positive is I can move this base up to the numerator. Move the base up to the numerator. And so instead of being in the denominator, it's going to be in the numerator. So I have my 1 times. So I'm going to take my base of x and I move it up to the numerator. And if I move it up to the numerator, what I have to do is make my exponent that have the opposite sign. So if it's negative 4 when my x is in the denominator, it's going to be positive 4 when my x is in the numerator. So we get negative 1 times x to the 4th, which is just negative x to the 4th. Similar to this, to the last one that we did. So negative 2x to the negative 5. The x to the negative 5 is in the denominator, and I want to use only positive exponents. So I'm going to take my x, I'm going to move it up to the top. And by moving the x up to the top, I have to take its power and use the opposite sign. So instead of the power being negative 5, it needs to be positive 5. So again, we get negative 2. So this is out of the denominator now, and it's just going to be a 1 in the denominator. So negative 2x to the power of positive 5. Right, so let's just do one last one using the shortcut. So if I have 1 over 4x to the negative 6. Okay, this 4, it doesn't have a negative exponent attached to it, so it's going to stay right where it is. X to the negative 6, well, this x is being raised to a negative exponent. So I'm going to take this x and move it up to the numerator. All right, so now it's gone. And instead of its power being negative 6, it's going to be a power of positive 6. So this ends up being 1 times x to the 6, or x to the 6, divided by 4. Okay, I'm going to give you a bunch of different types of examples to work on simplifying so that we don't have negative exponents. And then I'm going to have you press pause while you try them. Okay, press pause while you work on these 6 examples. Okay, for the first one, 7 to the negative 2, you should have gotten 1 divided by 7 to the power of positive 2, which is equal to 1 divided by 49. 1 over 2 to the negative 3. Well, you should have said, okay, I can take this 2 and bring it up to the numerator. So I'm going to get 1 times 2. So now it's gone from the denominator, and it's replaced with a 1. And instead of having my power of 2 be negative 3, my power of 2 is going to be positive 3. So it's equal to 1 times 2 cubed over 1, but we don't need to put that. And 2 cubed is 8, so this is 1 times 8, which is simply 8. So you should have gotten 8 for that one. All right, for this one here, negative 1/4 to the power of negative 2. So it's going to be 1 over, our base is negative 1/4. So we take our base and now raise it to the power of positive 2. So that's going to be 1 over negative 1/4 squared becomes positive 1/16. And 1 over 1/16 is simply equal to 16, which you can guess by dividing these two fractions. All right, 2 over x to the negative 3. I'm going to do this one in two ways, just as a reminder of this shortcut. So the first way we could do it is we could say, all right, this is 2 over 1 over x to the negative 3 is 1 over x to the positive 3. So this is equal to 2 over 1 times the reciprocal of this denominator, x cubed over 1. And 2 over 1 times x cubed over 1 is 2x cubed over 1. So simply 2x cubed. And then the shortcut was, we can take this x, bring it into the numerator, so times x, and then we're going to put the power, but that x is gone and it's replaced with a 1. And instead of it having a power of negative 3, it's going to have a power of positive 3. So now this is gone. So we get 2x cubed over 1, which is simply 2x cubed. Okay, so in this case, I'm going to show you the long way, and then I'm going to show you another shortcut. So the long way is we say, all right, this is 7a cubed. That doesn't have a negative exponent, so we can leave it how it is. So 7a cubed times, we're going to rewrite just this portion with a positive exponent. So b to the negative 4 is 1 over b to the positive 4. So 7a cubed times 1 over b to the 4th, so I'll put that over 1, so we have two fractions being multiplied. So we get 7a cubed times 1, which is equal to 7a cubed, over 1 times b to the fourth, which is b to the fourth. Or we can use a shortcut again. We can say, all right, since my negative power is in the top, I'm going to do a similar thing to what we did right here. When my negative power is in the bottom, I put the base in the top. Here, when my negative power is in the top, I can put my base in the bottom. But instead of having a power of negative 4, it's now going to have a power of positive 4. Okay, and so that just gets replaced with 1, so times 1. So I get 7a cubed times 1, which is 7a cubed over b to the 4th. All right, so let's do this one with the shortcut. So the 4 and the z, they do not have negative exponents, so they're going to stay right where they are. But the x and the y do have negative exponents, so they're both going to go down into the denominator. So this x goes down, and instead of having a power of negative 5, it's going to have a power of positive 5. This y goes down, and again, everything's going down as being multiplied. So x to the fifth times y, instead of having a power of negative 3, it's going to have a power of positive 3. So it's going to be 4z divided by x to the fifth, y cubed. All right, for my last example, I'm just going to show you one more shortcut. So if I have a fraction being raised to a negative exponent, the quick way that I can change everything to a positive exponent is to take the fraction, which is my base, and write its reciprocal. So 2/3, I'm going to write the reciprocal of 2/3, that's 3/2. So when I take the reciprocal of the base, I should then take the exponent and make it positive. Okay, so once again, I take the reciprocal of my base, and in turn, I must make my exponent have the opposite sign. So this is 3/2 squared, which is 9/4. So let's look at the rationale as to why we have defined a number to the power of 0 and negative exponents the way we have. So let's take a look at this pattern. 5 to the 4th, and then below that I have 5 cubed. So each one below, I have one less in the exponent. So 5 to the 4th, that's 5 times 5 times 5 times 5. And 5 cubed is 5 times 5 times 5. So to get from 5 to the 4th to 5 cubed, we simply divide by 5. Okay, so this divided by 5 leaves us with 5 times 5 times 5. Similarly, 5 cubed is 5 times 5 times 5, whereas 5 squared is 5 times 5. So to get from 5 cubed to 5 squared, we divide by 5. And the same thing is going to happen to get from 5 squared to 5 to the first. So likewise, we can expect to get from 5 to the first to 5 to the power of 0, we should divide by 5 again. So if we have 5 and we divide it by 5, we get 1. To get from 5 to the power of 0 to 5 to the power of negative 1, we should again divide by 5. So divided by 5, 1 divided by 5 is 1/5. To get from 5 to the negative 1 to 5 to the negative 2, we should divide by 5 again. And so 1/5 divided by 5, that's going to be 1 over 5 squared, which is 1 over 25. Okay, so if you read a few different sources, you might see a few different explanations as to why it makes sense that we define these the way that we do, but here's one idea to illustrate why it's true.